Hello everyone, I welcome you all in lecture number 7 of the Human Eye and the Colorful World. Today we are going to discuss about two more points, that is scattering of the light and Tyndall effect and why the color of the sky is blue. So first we are talking about the scattering of the light. So what do you understand by the scattering of the light? So first of all, I am going to show you some of the examples by which you can easily understand that what is the scattering of the light. So here you can see that sky color is having blue. Why sky is representing as a blue color, not red color, white color or black color? Why it is shown blue? Next, as you can see that the deep of the ocean, the water having also the color of blue. On the sunset and sunrise, you can observe that the sun becomes reddish and the atmospheric become reddish. Why this happens? And that is due to the scattering of the light. So whenever the light, white light, is impinging on the smaller particles like dust is there, then water droplets are there, then different types of gases are there. These are the different molecules that is having a very small size. So whenever the light rays are impinging on this type of smaller particles, then the wavelength which is having the minimum out of that the white light, out of that the white light, the color which is having the minimum wavelength, it will be come out of that particle. And so that's why we can say that the blue color is having the minimum wavelength, so the sky appears blue due to the effect of the scattering of the light. The water, deep water inside the sea, it also becomes blue because the smaller particles after scattering of the light, only the blue color is coming outside from that particle. And that is the reason why the sun is appearing reddish while sunrise or sunset. Now we are talking about the Tyndall effect. Now what is Tyndall effect? So you have observed this type of image in the jungles whenever you are visiting some of the hilly areas like Saputara, Mount Abu, Mahabaleswar. So on that hilly areas, whenever you are wandering here and there and in the jungles, you have find this type of nature, that one gap is there and from that gap the different white light beams are coming and you can see the path of the white light. That is known as the Tyndall effect. So Tyndall effect can be observed in the room, in a dark room which is having only one glass, or we can say that only one hall in the house. So at that time you can also see the path of the light. That is known as the Tyndall effect. On so many places you can see the Tyndall effect. So what is actually a Tyndall effect? So as you know that the Earth's atmosphere is the heterogeneous mixture of the so many particles like gases, dust particles, water droplets, etc. This particle will include smoke, tiny water droplets, suspended particles of dust and molecules of the air. So whenever the beam of the light strike on such fine particles, the path of the beam becomes visible like this, as we have seen in this figure. So that is known as the Tyndall effect. So the light reaches us after reflected, diffused by these particles, and this phenomena is known as the Tyndall effect. So the Tyndall effect, whenever the light rays are passing on the different types of particles, which color has to come out, that is depending on the particle's size. So very fine particles the scatter mainly blue light, while the particles of larger size scatter light of the longer wavelength. A longer wavelength is having a red color and white color. So the size of the scattering particle is large enough, then the scattered light may be even appear white. So if the smaller size of particle will be there, then the light will be appear blue. If medium size particle will be there, then the light that will be appear reddish. And if it is too large, it is large enough, then the scattered light may be even white. Next, basis on this, we are going to understand why the color of the clean sky is blue. So as we have seen in the previous figure, again we are going to see that why the sky is appearing blue. So the reason is that the molecules of the air and fine particles from the atmosphere is having the size smaller than the wavelength of the visible light. So these are more effective in scattering light of the shorter wavelength at the blue and then light of the longer wavelength at the red end. One of the research states that the red light is having the wavelength about 1.8 times greater than the blue light. So we can say that whenever the light ray is impinging on the smaller particles, which wavelength color will be there? Only blue. So as you know that the atmospheric is having so many number of smaller particles, like we have seen that smoke particles are there, dust particles are there, droplets are there, gases are there. So whenever it is impinging on this type of smaller particle, which color will come out? Only blue. So the sky is appearing blue. So this is the reason why the sky is appearing blue. It is depending on the scattering of the light. I think all of you are clear about these two phenomena. Thank you.